Don't miss your chance on winning this Defender Outback Mini 2.0 crawler. On the 27th of June, we're going to have a raffle with all the subscribers, so make sure you subscribe. Then I'm going to ship this car to the lucky winner. So subscribe and it could be you. So let's get back into today's video. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the winner, first place on the podium, the Falestis. Now this week I want to show you 5 upgrades that you can do to the DFS4 crawler. And on top of that, I'm just going to add a light kit to it to shine out the track at night. The first upgrade I want to talk to you guys about is tires. First thing you actually want to do is get the car a little bit higher off the ground, specifically because it doesn't have portal axles. You want the pumpkin or the diff to sit higher off the ground. With its stock tires, the diff sits too low and you constantly get hooked up at it. So you want to choose a bigger diameter tire than the original. So let's begin with the diameter. The original diameter is 11.9 centimeters. Let me just go to the next one. This one, without squeezing the tire at all, the diameter lies by 13, and the biggest one we have, 13.7. So what that means is I'm going to put the tire onto the front axle and measure the height of the pumpkin to the floor. Now with its original tires on, the height of the diff, so the pumpkin sits at 2.7 centimeters off the ground. I'm going to put the medium sized tires on. Now I've got the 13 centimeter diameter on, and the diff height is 3.4 centimeters off the ground. Putting the last set of tires on. So with the biggest diameter tires that I've got on here, I get the diff approximately 4 centimeters off the ground. Now the second upgrade is when you're choosing your tire, you want to go with a wider grip. The reason why you want to do this is so the stance of your vehicle becomes wider. I've installed the original tires. I'm going to measure the distance from the outside to the outside, from the left tire to the right tire. And that is exactly 23.5 centimeters. Taking the original tires off, you need to make sure when you buy your new set of tires that the offset of the hexagon that you've got on here is not in the center, that it's a little bit offset, so the tire comes out a little bit more. So if I were to put these on and measure again, so these are 26 centimeters in width, allowing the car to go over a steeper obstacle without falling over. And last but not least, we're going to install the monster truck tires and see how wide they are. I have a distance of 27 centimeters. Okay, that was tire size. The second upgrade is when you're buying your new rims with tires, make sure that your rims are wider than the original. So if I squeeze this tire and I get my caliper to go to the actual rim, the rim width on the original tire is 2.6. If I were to take now this beadlock that I have over here and squeeze the tire to touch the rim, this rim is 4 centimeters. Not just that it's 4 centimeters, it has an offset hexagon. And measuring the monster truck tire, this rim is 5.1 centimeters, giving me even more width in the car. And the third upgrade I want to talk about is placing weight. So I have a couple of brass weights that have been cut out. You can use anything. So it can be from about 40 grams to 60 grams per unit. And you can place them underneath the chassis and try to place them as low as you can. So with positioning them, you have a couple of options. You can take two of them, put one just in front of the servo underneath the bumper, On the back of the chassis, you have two options. One, just underneath the battery tray, or you can mount it to the bumper setup, up to you. And the next upgrade I want to talk about is weight in the wheels. So when you're getting your new wheels, and before you install them and glue them together, or if you have beadlocks, you can actually take them apart because the beadlocks are not glued onto the rim. So why you want to put weight on the actual rim of the wheel is the weight is very low down, as low as you can actually get it. So it's actually keeping the tire on the rock. So if you have an articulation, the tire is always trying to push down. So the heavier you can make the rim, the better it is. Now there are a couple of ways how you can add weight to this. I find the easiest way is soldering wire. You get different thicknesses and different weights of soldering wire, but if you pick this up, this is already like 200 grams. So I would suggest going between 30 grams and 60 grams per wheel. And how you would do that is you cut a certain length off, place it on your scale, and make sure that all of them have the equal weight. Once you've done that, you can actually just tape it down so that it doesn't move. Just try and place it as close to each other as you can. Always give it a bit of a push. And while you're winding it up, just make sure they're touching each other. Don't have any overlaps to try and keep the balance of the wheel as close to original as possible. So there we go, absolutely perfect. And I'm going to tape it down so that it doesn't move in the future. And this is what it looks like, completely even, one layer, and this gives me 40 grams per wheel. Now you would want to have a nice balance. Don't put too much weight onto the chassis because it starts to be top heavy. If you start adding and adding weight onto the chassis, it's just going to pull the car over. So you need to find a good balance of say 50 grams in the front of the car, 50 grams in the rear of the car, plus you have around 30 to 50 grams per tire pulling down onto the ground or keeping you on the rocks. So all you do, stick the tire back in, pull it over its lip, and the rear, and your tire is ready for gluing. So the last upgrade is changing the shock oil to a 10 weight. When you purchase this car, you will notice after a while the shocks become a bit sticky. There's nothing wrong with these shocks. You don't have to now go spend money and replace them. All you need to do is take the oil out and change the oil to a 10 weight. So I'm going to install the weights onto the chassis, install the weighted tires, change the oils, and let's go on to the trail. Okay, let's sum it up. We have got bigger diameter tires to get the diff higher off the ground. Number two, we have wider tires. Number three, we have weights that we're going to place into the chassis. Number four, we have weights that we've added to the wheels. And number five, we are changing the shock oil to a 10 weight. Quickly going to install a light kit from the China shop for €3.50. So on that run, you saw that the car was much steadier. It had contact to the rocks at all times. It effortlessly crawled up that hill, where in the last two races, you saw it was battling and wheel spinning quite a lot, and you saw it sliding off the side of the track. This time, it literally just walked up as if it was nothing. From the light kit point of view, it's just something I added for a night run. But other than that, the 10 weight in the shocks, adding bigger wheels, getting the diff higher off the ground, getting wider wheels to get the stance of the car wider so it doesn't tip over so easily. Got quite a improvement on that. Putting the weights in the tire and placing the weights in the front and the rear. We have clearance on the servo on the weights. You need to watch out for that. Other than that, the car is a lot better than when it came out of the box. So that's it for this week, my friends. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the channel. Click that notification bell, give me a like, and we'll see you guys next week. Bye.